Hey everyone, in this video I will be showing you how to perform stability test by using OCCT software. So first I'll be showing you how to download and install it, and later we can perform the test. So let's get started. First thing, just Google OCCT. We'll be getting the first link from ocbase.com. Click it, and here we are having a download option. Select this, and our focus is on Windows, and they are having the personal edition, which is the free one. Apart from that, they are having Pro, Enterprise, and this CMD. All these things are paid. You have to purchase it. The personal one is free, and this is for Windows. If you want to do the same for Linux, you can do that. Here just go with the stable one and select this agreement and click on download. Download will be getting started around 280 MB in size, so just be patient till then. So once the download is complete, just open it, and we'll be getting the license. Just click on accept, and we'll be getting automatically the OCCT personal interface. If you want to like open it anytime, you can just search it like this. You'll be getting the app and you can simply open it. And here we are having multiple options, from stability testing to benchmark monitoring system info. So stability testing is basically testing each and every part of your hardware. As you can see, we can test CPU plus RAM, CPU alone, memory, our VRAM, storage, power, etc. And we can even customize the testing that we are doing, whether to do just a shallow testing or an extreme testing. For example, if I go to CPU, we are having load type, variable and steady, and we are having mode, normal and extreme. So that's with stability testing. We can come to that later. And stability certificate, I guess this is a paid feature. And then we are having the benchmark. So similar to that, here also we are having so many customization options. We can find the benchmark for CPU, memory, latency and storage. And next we are having monitoring. So this will basically show the temperature. We are having CPU temperature, GPU, and we're having the fan, all the other stuff, the clock, everything. You can just go through it. And next, we're having the system info. This basically gives us the model name along with the configuration. I'm having here the Intel CPU, graphics card, and the motherboard. So you can get that. And next, we're having the settings. So all these are available in the free versions. That's so amazing. So now let me show you a sample testing. So let me just test my VRAM. I'm selecting it, and next here we need to change the duration. So I will just go with 15 minutes. So I would recommend you test between 30 minutes to 1 hour. So this is just a demo, that's why I'm going with 15 minutes. So once you have selected the necessary component which you want to test, so in my case I'm just going with this. So basically, depending upon your use case, you can select power, storage, memory, everything, okay? So initially, just test with the default settings, what they have given. After that, play around with extreme, steady, and other stuff, okay? So click on VRAM, I'm going with 80% memory, that is fine. And change the duration, and click on start. So we'll be able to start in like 10 seconds, and they're also having the paid subscription also. If you want to get that, you can also get that. So now we are clear. I will just click on start. So the testing will go on, and here you can see this is the time that is being elapsed, and we are having the logs also. VRAM initializing, VRAM started, and at the moment it says no errors detected, which means that the testing is going good and our VRAM is performing very well. And in case if it finds any issues, it will directly send you an error over here. I will also show you that. And while the test is going over here, we can monitor the other stuff also, the temperature and everything. And another important thing, when testing any component, make sure that you don't have any application running in the background, okay? Make sure that all the applications are closed and only you are having OCCT opened when the test is going. So here, as you can see, 15 minutes have been passed, and I didn't get any errors. So it says no errors detected, and 15 minutes have been completed. Now if I go back, and if I go to CPU, and in my CPU I'm actually having some errors, okay? So if I just click on start after selecting the duration, so click on start here. So here, as you can see, right, the test has crashed. The reason is because there is some issue with my CPU or hardware and the test has been crashed. And I did the exact same test in my other laptop and it worked perfectly. The CPU test passed. So by this way, we can detect which particular hardware is faulty in our system. So if there is no issue in your CPU, similar to the VRAM, everything will pass. The test will run for 15 minutes and you'll be getting test completed. So this is quite handy in detecting the faulty hardware. So that's basically it, guys. This is how you do the stability test. And if you want to do benchmark, literally the same, select the component and select the configuration that you want to test and click on start. That's the video, guys. Do check the playlist of my channel. Done a lot of videos in programming and AI tools. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.